So we will now derive the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, and the derivation is some of the portion is done in DJ Griffiths, and the Cauchy-Schwarz inequality is used there in order to prove the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. We will deviate a little bit from that, and we will basically start from scratch and from the orthonormality condition and the Hermitian operators. We will try to prove this in very simple way. We know that the orthonormality condition is that if I will have normalized wave functions, are which I call the bases of Hilbert space, then I can write that phi m is equal to delta mn. So if this is equal to, if m will be equal or not equal to n, I will have 0 for m not equals n, and this will be equal to 1 for m equal n. So this value is actually fluctuating between 0 and 1. So I can write this that phi m is greater or equal to, like I use 0 here, then when it will be equal to 0, then we will have this condition, and when it will be greater than 0, so the maximum value it can go will be 1. So I can write like this, and now removing the subscript from it because we don't need them. So phi and phi greater are equal to 0. So now we will have to actually prove the that sigma x sigma p is greater or equal to h bar over 2, which normally is written is delta x delta p is greater or equal to h bar over 2. But here delta is not a change, here delta is the variation or the uncertainty. Now let's consider two operators A and B, and these operators are Hermitian operators. These are Hermitian operators such that when these Hermitian operators operates on a wave function A psi, so this is giving an eigenvalue A, and similarly when B operates on psi, it gives B psi. Now this one I can write as we normally write the eigenvalue problem, A minus A psi is equal to 0, and B minus B psi is equal to 0. So now I can write their respective uncertainties is sigma A squared. If I write sigma A squared, then this will be the expectation value here of A minus A. So if I forget the symbol, this hat on it, so ignore this one, it means it is the operator A, and sigma B squared is equal to B minus B squared. So we will have to write square here and square here, the expectation value like that. So I can write that sigma a square, this is equal, if I want to write the expectation value, then I will multiply sign with this in the bra and ket notation. So sign here, and then a minus a squared psi. So this will be sigma a squared. Similarly, sigma b squared I can write is psi b minus b squared psi. So after incorporating all these, now is we know that if A and B are Hermitian operators, then any linear combination of these operators will also be a Hermitian operator. So I am designing another operator which I am writing is A minus A plus I lambda and B minus B. Now I is simple iota and lambda is any constant number. So this is any constant, and this will I will operate this on the wave function psi. So this will be, let's say when this operates on our wave function which we have used here, then this change the wave function to, let's say, this psi. So with this symbol over it for the recognition, so I write that A minus A plus I lambda and B minus B, this operates on our wave function psi, and this is equal to psi. So this changes our wave function to this, and now is the any linear combination of a Hermitian operators is also a Hermitian operator, and when we are having this psi, is the result or the change of this psi is giving this wave function, then I can write that this will also accept or will also satisfy our inequality which is here. So this is also true for this function as well, that psi and psi will be greater or equal to zero. So we now actually we are having this relation, but we want to find out the bra vector for this psi, that what will be this bra vector here, and let me derive this one. So the bra vector will be, this is, let me a little bit come here, and this is equal to, I will have to write psi and like this, and then my vector which is A minus A plus I lambda and B minus B, and I just enclose this one, I just enclose this one, and then I will have to take the dagger of it. Okay, then I will have to take the dagger, because when it is like this and I take the dagger of it, then it will be like this. So I take the dagger of it, because I'm changing the kit notation into the bra notation, so it will be equal to, this will remain as it is, psi. And what will happen to this one if I take the transpose and the conjugate of this one? So the transpose will have no effect here, and we will have only the change of this sign. So this is a minus a here, minus I lambda and b minus b here, and our final, okay, we are having here, so there is no need for this one. Okay, so now we will have now the bra here and the kit here. So we put this in this inequality, so this implies that psi and psi greater or equal to 0 implies that psi, and this will be the first one, this one, which is a minus I lambda and b minus b here, and enclose this one in a bracket, and then we will have our this operator a minus a and plus I lambda and b minus b, and enclose this one and our psi here, and this is greater or equal to 0. Now we will have to simplify this one, and to do simplification we will have to multiply these values. So let me multiply these values, and what will be the product? Okay, we will have the simplification of this one is, when this one will multiply with this one, so we will get a minus a whole square, and then minus here and plus here, so this is minus n I square is again minus, so we will have plus lambda squared and b minus b squared. Similarly, now this one will multiply with this, and this will multiply with, this one will multiply with this, and then this one will multiply with this. So we will have I lambda is common. So when this one is multiplying with this, I lambda is common, and when this is multiplying with this, I lambda is common. So let me take I lambda is common, and then do the product. So the product will be, when this is multiplying with this, so we will have a minus a, so the big bracket here, and a minus a multiplied with b minus b here, and then minus will come in, and this will multiply with this. So we will have b minus b and a minus a, and the bracket will close here. And this thing will be then further simplified. If I locate this relation, then this is a minus a, b minus b, and then b minus b, and this is like the commutation relation of a minus a and b minus b. So this is sort of commutation between this and this. So I will have to simplify now my calculation, and what I will get, I will have a minus a square means this one, I will have the a minus a whole squared, so psi and a minus a whole squared, and I will write psi with it because this psi is multiplied over here, and plus lambda square, and then psi and b minus b whole square and psi.